mind that you're discussing, you don't need too much information, but I'd left it on there, so I was thinking something about what happened, but it hasn't, so...
Fine. So, 11 then, Clark's report.
I made it, Madam Chair. 11.1, I ask your agreement to remove the meeting scheduled for the 16th to the 23rd. It helps me with staffing and compliance with the agenda. Mr. Melanie, I believe at certain points, so I don't know whether to stop, but it would be very grateful if you'd agree to a 1 week.
I would agree, I'm actually away that day. Yes, we can agree,
even though we may not be there.
I won't be there.
I will be on holiday, but my deputy will take the meeting.
Yeah,
it is holiday season, so if no one...
Yes.
Please put your hand up if you object. If you object. No, so that's okay then. Just please send your apology.
I'm taking that as read and you're happy to move it. Thank you, councillors.
Thank you.
If you may, at point two, it's an item that's been under some discussion, and I apologise earlier, Councillor Souter, it is a subject which I basically, I think you know the question and it's been councillors have debated. I made a resolution to instruct me to go through NELC, the Linkage Association, directly to NELC, the National Association, to get a definitive opinion with some other information that I will furnish to you so I can come back to you on this subject.
Councillor Graves.
Can I propose a support recommendation, Madam Chair?
Thank you. Do we have a seconder, Councillor Allen?
No. I want to ask a question.
Please ask the question.
Could we have the answer from LALC? What is the reply to our queries?
But I can say, yeah, LALC have confirmed that my interpretation of the rules as regards eligibility, that co-opted councillors are not eligible. But it's contrary to some other advice I've been given from another source, so hence I do need... LALC will only pursue it through NELC, the rules of my request, but they need a resolution from council, and I need to I need to get that from you.
So,
for
the proposal, can we...
Just before we propose, I want to ask a question or make a comment. I'm very baffled by this, because I've been a councillor for 5 years. There have been co-opted councillors over that period. I was a co-opted councillor to begin with, and then I was elected. And we've had previous clerks, and the allowance, if a person chooses to keep it, whether they're co-opted, elected, or they go for election, but, you know, they walk in, that's all it is, because...
All we're discussing now is whether we get...
I know, but what I'm saying is...
We would like
I would, but I am baffled as to why this has occurred.
Yes,
that's
as we all are, actually.
Yeah.
But we've got a proposal. Do we have a second there?
I put a proposal forward. Oh, okay. Apologising for the advice that we should receive to make sure that we're not led down the path.
Okay.
I do apologise, Madam Chair. Yeah. I did read.
Because we needed to instruct the clerk, and I put forward the
warning.
We should put the matter.
Make sure we get. We ask the right question.
Okay. I agree, and I said that I'm seeking your instruction. I'm happy to take to add all the information that I've gleaned all over the last 10 days from a number of
So, Councillor Graves, you propose that we make this. That we make this inquiry. If you're happy with these words, then that would be your. If you're happy, because I'm aware that we've had the proposal. Okay. Just the wording. No, I absolutely.
Yeah.
Councillor Graves is in favour of us asking the question,
yeah.
And you have provided
suggested
word.
Yeah, that's sure. I just need
Fine.
A resolution while I'll deal with it.
Councillor Souter.
It does concern me if we've paid people for a number of years.
But I
think there's also the question as to whether Northwest even, when they reviewed it for us, because as you realise, it's the remuneration how much North West Even that sets allowances. It should say in the remuneration panel's recommendation that it's only be paid to elected councillors. So I'll be very concerned if North West Even have sent us down the wrong direction.
Well, we need to find out first where we should be, and then we can look back and look forward and sort things out, I think. But we need to get this sorted out at source. So, Councillor Graves, would you like to come back?
I'm only coming back to say I support being worthy, because that is, I've had to undertake my own research, and that is the number of the issue. Constitutes an elected council, and it is interpreted differently by different authorities.
Thank you. And Councillor Coyne?
I was just going to say that is.
Okay, so can we just have a moment to. Oh, yeah,
I just want to say that I support a motion going forward to the part of the proceedings.
I need a moment to read it.
We quite clearly have individual opinions around the room. I have to say that I'm not optimistic that this will actually be resolved, and I see this because it's a question that I've gone through the legislation, it's a question of interpretation. And it's interpretation of the legal situation. The only way that this can ultimately be resolved is in the High Court, I'm afraid to say.
So we have the wording, we've got a proposal, and do we have a seconder? Yeah, Councillor Brown is seconding. So if everyone is happy with this wording, where we're in fact determining what is meant by an elected council, because that is the number of it. All those in favour, please.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12 hands up, I'm
checking. And against? 2.
2 against.
And no abstentions.
Do you want to explain?
No. That's
fine.
Not at all.
Thank you.
Everybody's got individual opinions.
I think it was the wrong word.
Thank you. Okay, and 11 points.
Oh, yes, if I may. Sorry, Madam Chair, I've turned over by myself. 11.3, I'll review the Constitution. I think you mentioned certain chapters are over.
Yeah.
Chapters 1 to 4, again, still welcome to get any offerings. We've still got time, Kesters. My colleague Melody will be sitting
should
down.
Shouldn't have been by today.
Yes,
okay.
Agree.
We will, it was proposed before that Councillor Shanahan approve and us to sort of get it together and bring it back. Okay, so we will get together and sort it out. If I can have a week, have a word after the meeting, please.
Yes.
Thank you.
And I just say, ironically, linking back with our last item, there's another thing which we've got to look at in the Constitution, because regardless of what ends up as the legal outcome, with regard to allowances, we haven't actually got it covered in our constitution. So we need to bring us up to date in terms of remuneration and the right place.
Thank you. Yes, that's right. Thank you. So that now we're on to.
Can I, if you allow me, Madam Chair, I mentioned that a couple of other things, if you just allow me.
Oh, sorry, yes.
No, please. Just to say, if I can, would you let me just quickly read a thank you letter the council had. Briefly, I'll summarise. Seaford District Civic Trust would like to thank Seaford Town Council for acting to improve the appearance of the area adjacent to the River Slea, known as the Cut. A discontinued part of the formal navigation is owned by the Civic Trust, and they are working on plans to use the areas closer to the river for boat house and storage. But they are basically extremely grateful for the Council's Town Council's action in offering to provide manpower and expertise to ensure the Cut is now perfectly neat and tidy is much, much appreciated. You may have seen if some of you have been around here. I asked one of my operatives to go and sort it lovingly, bearing in mind the nature of this, and I think he's done that in fairness. So that's that one. Just two other things. Reminder again about social media, please. Speaking to the press, I know I said it last week, but again, please be careful how you present and that, because you can't avoid the fact that you are in a public position, you've always perceived that. And whether it's the press, and I will be speaking to the press again to remind them about rules of engagement. So that's that one. And the other thing I will be reporting back to is I probably met with the Environment Agency yesterday. Councillor Brown finally sat in with myself and three or four others, including the River Clean team, to at least have some clarity around who does what, and I'll try and put something off the back of that. We then walked around, we walked around areas of the town where the river is, because admittedly it is in a bit of a state, both in relation to what we can do, the river team can do, and the Lowdown Environment Agency. So I will give you more, it was a useful 2 hours together. And the river cleaning team are out this weekend, and they will be doing the core areas around the town that certainly visually are not in the best condition with the rubbish and that. So you will see them out this weekend.
Thank you.
Just to add on, thank you. I think it was very important that representatives from the environment actually did the walk with us.
Yeah.
Because in a sense, it's some time since they've actually done it. And, I won't say any more, but I think changes will be happening in the long term.
Thank you. That was a job well done.
Thank you.
Councillor Fernandez.
Will I be given the keys to the shed and everything else?
Yeah, could you get them off right for me?
Yeah,
no, that'll be lovely, thank you.
Okay,
so we're on to 12 now. We are indeed, yeah. Madam, I have a couple of items here. One is I realise that the agreement with North West Stephen for the management of the car park.
Oh, sorry, Councillor.
Oh. The agreement with the Sleaford Town, with North West Stephen has been sent to me, and I'm asking Councillor to peruse it, and I'm seeking agreement to sign it as such.
Who'd like to speak? Councillor Graves, Coyne, Fernandez and Brand. Yeah?
Graves, Coyne, Fernandez, Brand.
Yeah?
Graves, Coyne, Fernandez. GCF.
That's like playing a tune on the piano. Councillor Graves.
I would like to propose that we defer this to our next full council meeting, as I don't believe this is currently correct. In that agreement, it refers to a contribution to CCTV, which was in the previous agreement. However, on your budget report that you had, line 430 shows a £5,000 contribution towards CCTV. That contribution was over 3 years, as you probably heard me say before in this council meeting, was a contribution towards new digital cameras that was actually going to reduce considerably the operating costs of CCTV. Because that was in lieu of paying for the running costs of CCTV. So I think we're actually doubling our contribution towards them. It says that we would pay 25%. And under the old agreement, that was the case, because the council, as in North Castilla, actually put in the infrastructure costs at that point. In previous years, met with one of the officers of North Castilla, who was then to provide this council with details costings for the new runnings of the CCTV costs under the different arrangements that they proposed. And I'm not aware that that's actually come before council. So in agreeing to contribute 25% towards the CCTV, we don't actually know the amount that we're agreeing to contribute, or so I believe, because that's not been before council. So I don't understand why we're paying twice, because we certainly haven't agreed
twice.
Thank you.
If I can, you're probably more aware. This is only in relation to the CCTV in the car park, not the CCTV out in the main streets that we contribute to. So this only relates to the two cameras in Eastgate car park, as I understood it. Not the 9 new ones out in the town.
If I may come back, under the old agreement, we were contributing to the whole system. And it certainly doesn't say that in the agreement that we've got here. So I go back to, and unfortunately I only read this last night, Madam Chair, so I go back to, I'd like to defer it until the next full council meeting until we've had a chance to. I note it's a 10-year period, but there is a 12-month opt to review it, so that's not as onerous as it may be. Interesting that they are looking for such surety of contract when we can't obtain that from the same authority ourselves.
Okay, so if the deferment's been proposed.
Yes, seconded.
Could we have a seconder?
Seconded.
And not asking questions, but seconded. Yeah. Then there's no more discussion at the moment, I think, is that right?
No.
So there'll be no more discussion. If you vote for a deferment,
then we will get better information and it will come back to the table at an appropriate time. Is that correct?
Well, I'm happy with that. The only thing is, you've mentioned CCTV. If any of you have any other, because I will have to go back to NKDC for clarity, so if there are any points in here that you want me to follow up, you must let me know before the middle of next week so I can at least go back to the head of environment and such like. So if you, any of you want to look at it, please let me know. Don't come to the meeting on the 2nd and suddenly hit me with things that I can't answer for.
So I'm sure Councillor Graves will put into writing your concerns as soon as possible. Excellent. Thank you very much. So we've got a proposal and a seconder that we defer this until the next meeting. So could I have all those in favour, please?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
12. And against deferring and abstaining. Do we have a show?
2.
Thank you. Thank you, Councillor Graves. We need all the information before we make the decision. Thank you. And, yes, 12.2.
If I may, Madam Chair, is it me again? Yeah, 12.2, if you recall, I brought your report from the independent, about the security and the tracking shed. You asked me to go away and get a quote for CCTV covering the tractor shed and looking back towards this building. The two things in front of you are the CCTV solution from our present providers for two of our sites, and this, I brought to you also a suggestion that if you feel an intruder alarm, but you probably noticed there, I'm probably suggesting the intruder alarm would be a step too far, but it's a report I'm bringing back to you as per your request. So.
Who'd like to speak on this, please? Councillor Graves, Councillor Fernandez. Anyone else at this point? Councillor Graves.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would suggest with the intruder alarm, that £52 is an annual maintenance charge, not a monitoring charge, because I think that you wouldn't get it monitored for £52. To maintain that £52. But I'd like to propose that we actually do both, because the first question, if we ever have an issue in terms of theft, is was the premises alarmed? We know once we're running that, there is some valuable equipment in there. And even if we cost that £1,500 over 5 years, actually for peace of mind, I think it's a small price to pay to know that we've got valuable equipment protected. So I'll ask to reconsider whether we can afford to actually put the alarm in there also. I am appreciative that if there's an alarm in there and it is unreliable, it is very near a residential area. But equally, the construction of that building, if theft is to be made, as some people have seen, is they take a discus to the side and take the side out and they're away. And the only thing that possibly will deter them is that it is actually creating some noise once they come in. So I would propose that we reconsider whether we can afford an alarm system to do both in there.
Thank you. Councillor. Yes, thank you. So we've got a proposal and a seconder that we adopt this and we include the intruder alarm as well. And Councillor Fernandez?
Have we now got the lights to be infrared detected?
I'll ask the clerk.
What, the proposals with the cameras, you mean?
No, they're for the lights themselves. As you go all past at night, they automatically come on.
There are external lights on the shed.
Have they got an infrared detector so that anybody walking past will automatically switch them on?
I wouldn't know. They're going to test them, sir. I mean, that's not part of the brief I was given.
No, that's
no.
Separate.
No, these cameras do have infrared capability. Yeah. They are, because I'm very conscious if we broadly light up that area every time somebody walks past, I'm sure.
At night.
Yes.
But it would be so annoying for residents around to have these flashing lights every time someone walks around. So, on the CCTV it says 3 wireless infrared cameras.
Yeah, the ambient lighting supplemented by infrared lighting outside of daylight hours.
Yes.
Somebody understands what that means.
Fine. Councillor Gray.
If I may come back and tell Councillor Manders, we did say at the time, I think it was consensus, that there was no point in having CCTV. if it was too dark to actually see anything.
Yes.
I mean, it would be sensible to have a CCTV installed, and if the light isn't really adequate, I can assure you the company there will be soon back to you to tell you that you need to improve the lighting. However, we do that to mitigate the view of the residents there.
Thanks.
My cat, Madam Chair, said it does say £52 for the annual monitoring tonight.
Yes.
I think we just have to see what they're talking about for that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, yes.
So
we've got a proposal on the second that we
do both.
Do the whole thing. All those in favour, please.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Are you up, Councillor Dolby? No. 8, 9, 10, 14.
Thank you, Councillor.
And way ahead of time we are.
Yes.
So. So, 13.1. And this is where Councillor Allen is working. Thank you.
Right, you allow me just by way of introduction, I mean, councillors probably know where we're at. You made a resolution on the 7th of June regarding your intended disposal of land subject to the requirements of the public consultation. As many of you know, that was done as per the requirements of being listed in the press, so on and so forth. Giving you some basic information, I gave it quickly last week that I've had 8 pieces of correspondence back, which I've given you, which are on yellow pages. I do not have the permission of the individuals to circulate it, which is why it's been anonymised, and I would encourage all of you not to release any of that paper outside of this room. The 8 pieces of paper, and 12 people came into the office to look. Only 2 of the people that wrote to me have come in to look at the plan. That sort of gave me a problem. I actually have more people in subsequent to the consultation to have a look than before. But that aside, the legislation requires that we are obliged to show that we have considered the responses, which is why I've given you all copies you've been circulating by our solicitors. I've had sight of them. Our solicitors have had sight of them as well. Sorry, Martin. And offered no comment other than we must show that we have considered the responses. I'm confirming to you there about the nature. You can see by what some of the things have been written. I've confirmed to you that 2 of them do not live within Sleaford as part of that. The Fealty Trust have reconfirmed their agreement over what we talked about previously. And I have today, I think I should advise you, I have an adjacent landowner as confirmed today that they will further replace any trees that are lost as part of the visibility display. So I need to show now that you have considered in case how you want to do that as a process when you want to.
Information. We are still in open session, but we are
looking
at everything. Well, how can I talk about this?
Well, you cannot relate the name, that's all, and you don't know who the name is, sir. I mean, the information in the consultation is not. I'm giving you that is I am not allowed to give this, put this in the
room
with the names on. But you are welcome to refer to any point on this, sir. And I will have to answer it as best I can.
So the question is that we've gone out and asked for what we've publicised.
We've only asked for objections.
Yeah, we've publicised,
we've
asked for objections, and we've had 8.
8, well, one of those is an objection. I think 1 or 2 of them don't use the word objection.
No, okay, they're observations,
yes,
perhaps.
Thank you, thank you.
So the recommendation, if I can just reiterate, the recommendation is that we confirm our resolution. We've already made the resolution on the 7th of June. Had we, I'm suggesting that had we had thousands of letters, we may reconsider. We've had 8. So let's have comments, please. We've got Councillor Allen, Councillor Coyne, and Councillor Lorimer. Anyone else? And Councillor Souter. Thank you, then. Councillor Allen.
I don't consider this as a meaningful consultation. If having just 8 responses is not consultation, not even in a name. If public doesn't come to us, then we need to reach out to the public. We should mark down in the lake how many trees we're losing. We should mark out their area is for exchange, and we should reach out to the public and ask them questions on the street and making notes whether they are agreeing or disagreeing for the confrontation. Just having aid and having in paper where people have to buy paper is not consultation at all.
Thank you. That might be the clerk to reply as to whether we have complied with the law in as much as informing the public of our intentions.
The 1972 Act is very specific, section 127. We were obliged to advertise it in the local press for 2 consecutive weeks, which we did in both our local newspaper. We put it on our Facebook site, we put it on our website to try and further advance it. The plans, and I know you were perhaps all aware, the plans that we approved as a council were available in the office for anybody who wanted to come in. It did show the trees that were possibly going to be lost as part of the business, but it clearly showed the land that would be gained. So I do take the point. I'm disappointed with the response, but I am obliged by what the legislation has required of me as your clerk, or so you as a council.
We have complied with the
legislation. The solicitors have confirmed that through the.
It's not enough. We should reach out to the public.
Thank you. Councillor
Coyne. Thank you, Chair. We are required to show that we've considered the responses.
Yes,
I have personally read each and every one of them, and there is nothing in any of them which I believe would materially alter the resolution which this Council previously took on the 7th of June. So I would propose that we support the recommendation.
Thank you. Councillor
Lorimer. Yes, thank you. With a 15-day consultation period, I'm in total agreement with what Councillor Allen has just said. For one thing, a lot of people don't buy, a certain amount of people don't buy the local papers. 15 days in a holiday period when people are tootling off here, there and everywhere, to my mind, is not long enough. Secondly, I've read all the letters very carefully, as I do all the paperwork. And letter 2 categorically states, in May 2014, following a referendum held when 85% of Sleaford residents who voted were in favour of keeping the recreation ground. It was in St Denis Church, and there were an awful lot of people there. So, I've always maintained my objections to this, and when we vote tonight, I will be again.
Thank you. Thank you, Councillor Lorimer. I think you are referring to the proposal that was a different proposal to this one, with a different purpose, in as much as it was to commercially develop that land. It was to take a huge road, a lot of trees from our park, through the park, and it also involved a bridge and the closure of the crossing.
Yeah.
So that was a different matter that those people were consulted on.
Just as a right to reply briefly, the road, because I've been there for every part, yeah, as you know, the road is now going down the side of the wreck, near a play area. People enjoy that open space. It's about the last one left at Sleaford. So I am aware of the dichotomy between the two.
Thank you. Councillor Sita.
Of course, the law is the minimum that's required. In the past, we did have major consultations with the public as a council. A lot of people don't buy the local newspapers. I do recall in the past this started off at less than 3% and then it climbed to 9%. The requirements for the size of the road, the original road that was proposed quite a number of years ago, was less than 3%, and it increased around
9%.
Of the recreation ground.
It's not
9%
now.
It's not 9%, no, it's currently a very small proportion.
Yes.
But I do worry that it will increase. Since the consultation took place, members of the public have come to me with concern on seeing people with professional equipment on the on western side of the recreation ground,
okay, so we
placing blue blocks on trees.
We did talk about that at the beginning of the meeting, and if those people had made their concerns in writing to the council, they would have been considered. But I'm afraid people have spoken to me about their concerns, but I do not bring those to the meeting because they have not made an official representation. It's by the way. So, a second viewpoint.
Yes, it could finish.
Yes.
And I'm very concerned that someone goes around the recreation ground, appears to be looking at a much larger area. I do worry that somebody will come back later and say they want a larger area.
Did you want to reply?
Well, Councillor Sue, I don't know whether you were in the public session at the beginning. Were you?
Oh, I wasn't.
No,
just about
Mr. Dexter asked a question.
I asked a question. Yeah, I did ask the question.
It was answered.
So that's a specific answer about the tree forms on the trees.
I'm satisfied with the answer, but what David is saying, I'm also, and what this lady said about the public being consulted, the public is not consulted in the correct way. Nobody
I'm
reads,
afraid, I'm so sorry, but we're in session.
I know.
And I just can't allow you to speak. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, thank you anyway. Thanks. Did anyone else want to speak on this matter? You did. Councillor Dale, yes.
Basically, just to back up Councillor Coyne.
Thank you.
Really, we've done all we can in compliance with the law, the resolution was put forward. The public has a chance to actually do what they wanted to do, as in writing. It's clear that only enough people have written in, not enough people have written in to make a change. You can only take the horse to water, but you can't make it drink.
Thank you.
Really?
Thank you. Anyone else want to come in? Councillor, have you had to go yet? Oh, no, you haven't. Councillor Charlesworth and then Councillor Brown.
Yeah. I don't want to follow these arguments, but 4 years ago, it came through and they wanted to take up to 100 trees out of the road, right? You had a two-lane motorway coming out. And the big issue at the time, whether they took it to a compulsory purchase or not, we would lose the covenant on the wreck and then the whole of the wreck, the whole 13 acres. So long as we guarantee that that covenant is safe, and I take it legally, we've been advised it isn't, that it's safe, then I do believe that what is allotted out is far, far better, because we're actually gaining land, we're gaining trees than we ever were. And it's allowing access to a part of Sleaford called the Plantersheath site, which might make better use of it. So, on that basis of the government mobilisation, I still support.
Thank you. Councillor Barnes.
Thank you, Chair. I mean, really all I wanted to say is that I believe under this item we should actually be looking at responses and making a final decision. My worst fear is that we confirm the consent potentially around this table and partially terms of the letters. We're reopening discussions, which we had, which we, I believe, I thought we could resolve, whether the people like it, what we resolved or not. When you look at the letters objectively, there is, in a sense, a bit of confusion from some people in terms of what they believe they're commenting upon. It doesn't seem as though they're necessarily objectively commenting upon the current plans. I thought that the best letter was letter 5, which was the most literate, it is the best written letter, and it raises relevant points. It's not an objection letter.
No,
it's a very sensibly written letter which alerts us all the things with which we're already concerned about. So in actual fact, in terms of looking at the 8 letters, I can see nothing here that would materially affect
the previous decisions that we have made. We have consulted. Whether people don't think that the national requirements are sufficient, well, that's the national requirements. Take it up with your MP.
And would you like to come back, Councillor Coyne, for final word?
Thank you, Chair. It's basically a point because a number of people have said that we haven't consulted the public widely enough. What we have tonight is one member of the public who is concerned and has taken the time to come and sit through all of our meeting waiting for this final agenda item. Just to allay any suspicions, the REC is, and this is a matter of public record, so I'm not disclosing any of those all that's subject to any confidentiality, the REC is covered by two separate land registry titles. The vast majority of the REC is the original REC, which has been there for however many decades. The other part is which is required for a visibility display. It's listed under title number LL271341, and that is the part that was required. That has never been registered in anybody else's name other than Sleaford Town Council in recent years. Prior to that, it was not owned by the Bristol Estate. That is not subject to a covenant. So all this talk about do we in any way jeopardise the covenant? No, we do not. Because that part of the land which will provide the visibility sway to allow the development to take place has never been part of it.
Thank you. Thank you for all your comments. I know that they are heartfelt. I do understand that. So the recommendation is that the Council, having considered the letters received, confirms its resolution from the 7th of June 2017 to proceed with the land transaction and authorises the clerk to sign both the option agreements with the landowner and the agreement with Fields in Trust. Do we have a proposer?
Could I request a recorded vote, please,
before? Yeah, we can. That's fine. Yes. We have a proposer, Councillor Shanahan, and a seconder, Councillor Coyne. Thank you. And we're going to have a recorded vote. All those in favour of the recommendation, please show.
I'll shout the names out. Councillors Graves, Dolby, Shanahan, Booth, Dale, Richards, Coyne, Charlesworth, Brand, Matheson, and Clegg. Right, if we're being.
Yeah.
Can
we keep our hands up, please, children?
Melody. I'll go through it. Melody, we've got Stephanie, excuse me, using first names, Francesca, Paul, John, Anthony, and Jan. Yeah?
Okay.
Francesca,
yeah.
Paul, JC,
David,
JM, and SC.
Yeah.
Okay, how many is that? We just check.
Eight. Yep.
One, two, no, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
10.
We got 10?
Mark, Keith,
Melody,
Stephanie,
Paul, Francesca, John, Anthony, Jan,
and
Steve.
Thank you. So that should be 10.
Against, please show. Council.
Right, against, Councillor Mrs. Allen, Councillor Mr. Suter, Councillor Mrs. Honor. And that means it must be reception, Madam Chair.
And what? And the abstention, please. Thank you.
On the basis I've never seen any paperwork to this at all, whatever.
Thank you. So who was the other against? Was it Heather?
Yes, there's three heads.
Yeah.
I will, as a matter of course, Madam Scott, Madam Chair, respond to the people that read to me. Just as a matter of courtesy, and I will answer any direct questions raised.
Yes, thank you very much.
If you're happy for me to do that.
Thank you. Okay then, on that note, I declare this meeting is over at 8:25. Thank you for your cooperation. Thank you.